Okay, so boys and girls, this is Mrs. Hatfield, and today we're going to learn how to make an anchor chart. We use a lot of anchor charts in fourth grade for different subjects, and we use them as kind of like notes. I'm going to show you how to make one and put it in your three-ring binder that you have, and they're there for you to go back and look at in case you have questions. So it's kind of like your own personal little folder of notes. And things to go look at if you get stuck. So we're going to begin today by making an anchor chart with nouns. And what I need you to have is just a piece of notebook paper like I have and your crayons. I'm going to be using markers just so it shows up a little bit better, but you can use your crayons. Also, on the video, if I get ahead of you or you just need some time to catch up, you can go down to the bottom and hit the pause button, do your work, get caught up, and then hit the play button to continue. You can also go back and rewind it and carry on if you need to. So let's begin by making our first anchor chart. What I would like for you to do, we're going to be talking about nouns. So at the top, make sure that your three holes are on the left-hand side of your paper. And at the top, I want you to write a noun. And I am left-handed, so my hand gets in the way a lot. A noun is a. And this is a review. You already know what a noun is. You've learned that probably even in kindergarten and first grade, but we're going to review. So what I want you to do now is to come down to the second hole, and we're going to use that as a guide to draw a line straight across and divide our paper in half. And then we're going to make a line straight down and kind of make a big T there. Okay? All right. So you already know that a noun can be, one thing that a noun can be is a person. So let's write person right there, and then I'm going to draw a little person. And one thing, if you're in my class, you're going to find out is that Mrs. Hatfield is like the worst artist in the history, so don't mind my artwork. All right, so I'm just going to draw a little person, and you can draw, yours can be a stick person, it doesn't have to be fancy. You can get different colors, just however you want to draw your person is fine. I'm going to give my person some hair. You can color in your hair. Go back and do whatever you want to. And of course, my person's going to need a face. So here's my person. All right, let's talk about some people. A person, an example of a person. Let's start with me. I am a teacher. That is an example of a person. So I'm going to write that. A teacher, a boy, a girl, a doctor, a friend, a mom. Could be a person, our principal. And what I want you to notice that as I write all of these, I'm writing them with a lowercase first letter. And we'll talk about that more tomorrow. But these are all common nouns, so they begin with lowercase letters. I'm going to go ahead and add aunt. So you are welcome to add any kind of person in there you want to. All right? All right, so that finishes up our person. Let's now, we also know that a noun can be a place. So let's take the left-hand side over closest to our holes, and let's write place. And for a place, I'm just going to draw a house. How about that? Or it's some kind of building. Get put some windows and a door. Little chimney. All right, so let's think about some places. We know, of course, that we have a house. Our school is a place. And again, I'm using lowercase letters. A store. The mall is a place, my favorite place. The pumpkin patch, it won't be long until we'll be going to, or you'll be visiting pumpkin patches, hopefully. Your church, if you go to church, could be a place. So there are just lots of places. I'm going to say state. That is a place. All right, so there are our places. So one thing we have left. We know that a noun can be a person, a place, or a thing. So let's do thing. On the right-hand side down here. So we have a thing. All right, let's talk about some things. For the thing, I think I'm going to, just because you know, I've already told you what a horrible artist I am, I'm going to attempt to draw a pencil here. Let's see. Let's give it a tip or a point. Come down. We need a nice pink eraser at the end. Our pencils are most of the time yellow. We have our black tip here. All right, so there's my pencil. It's not beautiful. Yours doesn't have to be beautiful. It's just something there to remind you. So let's put pencil. We have a pencil. A car is a thing. Pets are things. A truck. A desk. Shoes. A balloon. Let's do a balloon. So any other things you want to add to your list, you are welcome to add other people, other places, and other things. But for right now, I'm just going to leave mine at that. So now I have made this little, we'll call it a little mini poster, and it is a reminder to me, in case I need help in the future, about what a noun is. A noun is a person, a place, and a thing. You were given a binder, and in that binder you have tabs. You have a tab for math, you have one for science, you have one for reading, it may say reading or LA, and you have one for Virginia Studies. Here is what I want you to do. I want you to find the tab that either says reading or LA, find that tab and pick it up and turn it over to the other side. Open your prongs here, and we're going to slide this right inside and close it. So now you have that neatly in there. You know where it is. You know that if you need some help with nouns, you can go to either reading or LA, flip it open, and there you have your own little personal poster about nouns. We'll be adding to this language arts section more this week, and you'll be adding to all of these different sections as we do what are called anchor charts throughout the year. So until tomorrow, I will see you.